I want to make one thing clear, and that is, on my channel, I do a lot of videos on technology and other stuff like that. But my channel takes a firm anti-nerd stance. Day of the Swirly cannot come soon enough. I am against nerds. I'm against nerds in pretty much every aspect. And in order to understand why I am against nerds, I think we need to dive into the psychology of nerds. Because there are a lot of you who might identify as nerds. You might feel, I don't know, your heart is going pitter-patter when you hear me saying that, but I think you'll understand when I explain it. Now, let me put it this way. Again, this might hurt someone's ego, but I think you all know that this is more or less true. Let's describe the psychology of a nerd. What is nerdogenesis? Where did nerds come from, okay? Now, nerds convince themselves of the following. They are in high school. Maybe they don't fit in exactly. Maybe they're not athletic. Maybe they're not particularly social. Maybe they're awkward. Maybe that's because they were born a little awkward. Maybe that's because they haven't been around or they don't have experience or something like this. But a nerd says to himself, I could try and be a jock. I could be athletic. I could be this or that. I could be more social. I could be this or that. But a nerd says, you know what? I'm not going to do that. I have a unique calling. I have a unique, and I'm like the chosen one. And what a nerd does, a nerd convinces himself that instead of messing with the unwashed normie masses or something like that, a nerd convinces himself that he has a calling to hyper-specialize in some little domain that other people can't touch. And that is just his goal in life. Now, there are things that are bad about this, but there are also things, this isn't necessarily a good representation of what's going on, because what often happens is that people who become nerds, they feel out of place, and their response to not feeling out of place is not trying to improve themselves. It is trying to run away, run away from social pressures, trying to run away from, you know, the expectation to be strong and competent and stuff like that. And they run away to AV club, or, you know, some, you know, little place where they can specialize. You know, maybe, oh, I'm gonna do a bunch of stuff on computers, and that's gonna be my thing. And they convince themselves, first off, that they're gonna be better than everyone else eventually. Revenge of the nerds, right? So, a nerd, I'm gonna get a six-figure job right out of college because I'm doing computer stuffs, while, you know, these unwashed normies, you know, these jocks, they're just going to be bagging groceries the rest of their lives. Now, first off, I've been out of high school for 10 years. Let me go ahead and tell you, that's not what happens, okay? All those jocks, well, pretty much all of them. Some of them actually were degenerates, but most of those jocks, guess what? They just got married, they had kids. Before they're 25, they have successful jobs, all that kind of stuff. And you know what? There are all those nerds out there. I still know them. They're like 30 years old. They're still smoking weed. They're, I don't know, watching anime and stuff like that. That's still how they are. They haven't improved at all. Because the problem with nerds is not that, you know, doing stuff with computers is bad or having some kind of passion is bad. What's wrong with nerds is that they're often in this mindset where they specialize in something because they want to say that this is their thing, it's their territory. They have a kind of territoriality with this specialization where they want to be masters of it. They want everyone else to not be able to tell them what they can do in that domain. I'm going to know everything about Unix system management, and that's going to be it. I don't need to know anything else. This is what I'm good at. I'm king of this world, and you can't do anything about it. And that's not a helpful mentality. Because first off, even if you specialize in something, even if you have something you are very knowledgeable about, you don't know everything. And sometimes you don't know everything even that a normal person might know. You know, someone who has never been experienced with your domain might come to it and have intuitions that you don't have. So it's never helpful. The nerdiness is often rationalized or motivated by this tendency for people to want to, escape criticism, escape others, you know, being superior to them in many ways. So they go into some specific domain that they think they're hiding from everyone else. They view their domain as just kind of a social identity. And they will run with that and they will identify themselves as a nerd. They will talk about how great it is, but their knowledge of everything is often really superficial. Again, because their motivations in being a nerd is egotistical. They don't actually want to go out there and improve themselves. They want to stake out a little claim on a little territorial domain and say, this is what I know about, you don't know about this, and this, you know, this is where my fragile ego lives. So this aspect of nerdiness I am very much opposed to. And this is, frankly, more often than not, this is what's happening nowadays. People, instead of being generally good people or trying to improve themselves, they choose one thing that they think they can be good at, and they, I don't know, just put the blinders on and run with it. Now, nerds will get mad at you when you say this is stupid, okay? If you call them out on this, or if you say something, you know, one thing that actually sort of annoys me is, you know, I'm a person, I do mostly technology stuff on my channel, but I do other things as well. In fact, in real life, if you've ever talked to me, I just don't talk about Linux. I don't talk about technology. It's just not something that's going to come up in a conversation with me unless you specifically ask, and I painfully have to be drugged through talking about it. It's not my identity. It's not something deep. But every once in a while, you'll have someone who sees my channel, and he sees that I put out technology content, and he will make the assumption that I am a nerd like him. This is the topic that I have chose to specialize in, and everything else that I do, I must be bad at. So if I have an opinion, keep in mind, you know, for example, I have a degree in economics. I've been relatively well-read in economics for over a decade now, well, much more than a decade now. So when I say something about economics, there are a lot of people who say, oh no, you're the technology guy. You couldn't possibly know anything about this, right? There are a bunch of internet hotshots who have read Proudhon or Rothbard or something and think they're God's gift to the world, when in reality, I'm sorry, a lot of us have been through that kind of path. You know, the idea that you can stake a claim on this one little territory that you're a nerd at and, you know, never have to deal with criticism, or you just have complete authority over it, that's just not healthy, and it's not even true. So the thing that annoys me, this psychology is one where nerds put themselves where, A, they can't improve themselves, and additionally, they're just boring people, you know? I just don't like the reason a lot of nerds don't get, social currency outside of their own domain is they don't know how to talk to normal people. Even when I was in graduate school, I still technically am in graduate school for linguistics. Well, when you're around people who specialize in some domain, and that's their commonality, we would talk about linguistics a whole lot, you know, at parties and stuff like this, just because it was a commonality. But what happens to a lot of these people is they become nerds in that domain. They become incapable of, you know, talking to their parents. And I mean, like, even me, this happened to me sometimes. I would go home and my parents would ask me what I'm doing, and everything I was doing was so specialized or stupid that it was incapable of, I couldn't even describe it to people. You know, especially in linguistics, where usually people hear you're in linguistics, they ask you, how many languages do you speak and stuff like this, where that's not necessarily what a linguist does. So the mentality that I don't like is being a nerd is not glorious, okay? It's not good to specialize in one particular thing. I don't do it. I don't condone doing it. I think that you should be good at pretty much everything you touch. I don't like the expression, jack of all trades and master of none, because that's what people who are bad at most things say. You know, nerds will say something like that. They'll say something like, oh, well, you might be good at a lot of things, but that just proves you're not good enough at any of them. No, that's not how it is. In reality, competence is compounding. If you're good at one thing, you often gain more intuitions that help you in other domains. In the same way, you know, the classic nerd mythology, the classic nerd Kinder fable is that there is a one-to-one trade-off between being intelligent and being strong. That's just not the case. Just because someone is strong or athletic or, you know, generally powerful, that does not make them dumber. You might have seen someone in their life who was both dumb and intelligent because maybe they could get or dumb and unintelligent because they could get away with one and not the other. But in reality, you know, one thing you find is that usually people who are competent in one domain happen to be competent in another domain. So maybe you should listen to them. As the video title might suggest, I do think that we should dab on nerds, you know, dab on them, okay? I dab on all you nerds, but it's not because I just want to lord over you. It's not because I think I'm better than you, even if I am better than you. It's that when you get dabbed on, when you get a little bant, you get a little bullied for your life decision to autistically specialize in something, hopefully it hits your brain that maybe it's not the best thing to do. You know, the world is not about, like, if you special, I mean, one of the problems in our economy nowadays is, you know, the people have this boomer mindset where I'm just going to do one thing, I'm going to get a job in that, and that job's going to be here in 10, 20 years, and everything's going to be fine, I'm going to be set for life. That's not how it is nowadays. I mean, it really was only how it was during the boomer economy, but, you know, all of life is an issue of you not necessarily specializing in one thing and being good, but just having the fluidity and having the low level of arrogance that's necessary to learn things in many different places, to be good at many different things. And I'm sorry, it's, you know, if you see someone who's better than you at something, if you see someone who's more buff than you, and your first response is to shoot them down and say, that doesn't actually matter, oh, you're just, you know, you're wasting your effort, that's stupid, or, you know, someone who's more intelligent than you. And mind you, I'm not saying that nerds are bad because nerds know too much about something. That's good that nerds know something about, you know, if you're a computer nerd and you know a lot about computers, that's good. But that does not exclude you from going and, you know, learning about other things. That's what I'm trying to say. So, again, if your response to someone is feeling inadequate, you're in a bad psychological state. And you, frankly, to be in a good psychological state would be just not evaluating other people. When you see them doing something that you can't do, you know, try and improve yourself. And if you see them failing at something that you can do, don't lord over them. It's not a competition. Or it is a competition, but it's a competition only with yourself. Anyway, so that's about it. Again, a dab on you nerds. Dab. I dab all over you. But the onus is on you to improve yourself. So anyway, that's about it.